Greetings all, it's the Devious Monkey here. What I want to talk about today is a much requested video about the Sigma 105 f1.4 Art Lens. This behemoth. I mean, look at how gigantic that is. Let me get my melon out of the way. It's even bigger than my melon. I mean, this thing is gigantic. And it's glorious. This lens has been out for quite a while now. I'm guessing like 3 years. So I'm not gonna go over a bunch of specs because that's been done to death. I'll say it one time, it is a bokeh beast. That's what it's known for. That f1.4, all this gigantic glass in all its gloriousness produces some amazing, amazing photos. It's sharp. The bokeh is just otherworldly. It's crazy. It's a fantastic lens. So again, I'm not gonna go over all the specs with the exception of this. This sumbitch is heavy. I wrote all this down after I weighed it yesterday. Now, the combination of the lens, in addition to the lens hood, which of course always stays on here, and the, I have a filter on here, and the collar, because you gotta have the collar on here. Filter size is 105 millimeters. So the filters are expensive and they're gonna add weight. So again, the lens, the hood, the filter, and the collar weigh in at a whopping 1.931 kilograms. It's like over three and a half pounds. It's crazy how heavy it is. This combination with the A7 R4, the grip, the lens with all the stuff connected to it, comes up to 3.019 kilograms. It's very heavy. Now, and I'm sorry for the noise here because I have the strap on, but that, giggity. But I wanted to show you what I use and why I use it that way. When I carry my A7 R4 around, most of the time it's with the 200 to 600 Sony lens because of all the birding that I do. That lens is just as heavy and it's a lot longer. You know, it sits differently. And the most important thing that I want you to take away from this is that that's a lot of weight to be putting on your mount point, all right? So, as you can see, I have a Black Rapid plate under there, and I have a Black Rapid plate on the lens collar. And you can see that I have my strap connected to the lens collar. Why? Because I don't want to put the strap on the camera so that when I'm holding it and it's dangling, it's not putting all the weight of the lens down at that point where it connects to the camera. I could be paranoid, I could be overly cautious, but I just think that there shouldn't be that much weight at that point. So I carry the 200 to 600 and this 105 from the collar mounting point. It's also a little bit more central, so it's a little bit more evenly weighted, and so on and so forth. Now, again, I have this strap, this Black Rapid strap, and you can see it has this little hook, and the hook goes through, and then why I got the Black Rapid plate here is because it has the little loop under there that tucks up inside, and then you put the hook on there, you screw it down, and then this little piece of plastic, after you screw that down so that it doesn't open, so the little carabiner portion doesn't open, you flip that piece of plastic over it, and now that's another way to lock that on there to make sure it does not come off. And then I have a fail safe. So I have this connected to the point on the camera where you would normally put a lens strap, and then it has a little carabiner, and then I stick it around the strap. Now, when I put this over on my shoulder, it all hangs down, but I have this second point of contact. If for some reason it disconnects at the plate, it's still gonna catch on the strap that's on my shoulder. The reason I use these straps is that it has this silicone portion on here that's part of the strap, and it makes it absolutely not slip off your shoulder. When you hang this on your shoulder, it stays right there. It's not going anywhere. Enough about lens safety, and you gotta do that because this thing is heavy. That's the one thing that everyone is gonna tell you in any review of this lens or anybody that uses this lens, they're gonna tell you, it's heavy. It gets cumbersome after a while. I took this whole setup around Virginia Beach one day. I drove through the Vibe District, walked around, took pictures. I took it down to the boardwalk and walked half the boardwalk back and forth, taking pictures of everybody. And then also ended up going to Pleasure House Point, where I do all the birding, and walking the entire park with this for the whole day. Was it heavy? Yes. Was it unmanageable? No. Was it excruciating? No. Because I had it properly weighted and strapped and everything so that it was sitting just right. And eventually you get a flow to it so that you know how to carry it and hold it. It is not for the faint of heart though, because it is heavy. So just keep that in mind. Once you've got that in your head and you've got it all set up so that it works for your flow, it will be just like any other camera setup that you're carrying. What I did was when I first got this lens, and this was back in September, I was busy. I didn't have time to take pictures. So it was a couple of weeks of me getting everything set up, ordering the filter kit, this, that, and the other thing, the strapping, getting it all fixed and set up the way that I wanted to. So a couple of weeks later, again, I went all over the place and I took some pictures. So this jet was flying overhead. And as you see, and a little addendum here, this is the JPEG version of the picture that I took, not the RAW. It's also completely unedited, and it's also a screenshot of the JPEG of the picture that I took because I didn't want to process it. I wanted to show you what everything looks like right out of the camera. And we all know YouTube's going to crush everything anyways, and it's going to look like crap. But look at how good this looks. Look at the detail that you can see on this plane. This is a jet plane. This is not a plane that was sitting in a parking lot somewhere that I walk up and took a picture of. This is me hand holding this freaking setup, taking a picture of a freaking fighter jet flying over me going out into the ocean. And I was able to snap this picture and look at the detail on that. You can see the freaking pilot in the cockpit. All right. So yes, this lens is amazing. As I moved down the boardwalk, and this was the weekend of the Neptune Festival, they were getting set up for it. I went the day before it officially started, and people were already getting set up and all that kind of stuff. So there was a lot of people on the boardwalk, on the beach. It was a gorgeous day out, and I happened to notice this little girl running along the beach, and she was all by herself, and she was having the time of her life. And I thought, all right, let's see what I can get here. And I snapped this picture of her, just capturing the joy of her just having fun playing on the beach all by herself. She wasn't really by herself. Her parents were sort of off frame, so don't worry. She wasn't like wandering around lost. But another good picture, and you can kind of see, you know, the detail that you can get with it. Working my way down the boardwalk then, I came across this gorgeous doggy. And keep in mind, it's not like I was kneeling down right next to it with a 35 millimeter lens. I was a good distance away to be able to get this shot. And it just sort of worked out perfectly that with all the people that were on the boardwalk that I was able to fire this picture and get the dog with no one else around. So look at the detail. Look at the razor sharp focal point of where you see what's in focus and what isn't. And that's the thing about this lens. If you crank this thing to f1.4, you are going to have a very, very small portion that is going to be in focus. So it's important, like if you're doing model portraiture and that kind of stuff, that, you know, you've got the eye focus on. And by the way, that works perfectly. The autofocus is perfect on this thing. The eye focus, though, it will catch that eye, and that is what is going to be in focus. The rest of everything is going to be blurred, and the background is just going to be gone. It is going to be super blurred out, which is kind of the whole point of this lens. I need to start shooting more human beings because that's why I got this lens. But even if I didn't, I mean, look what you can get. I mean, with the jet, the dog, just you can do landscape-y kind of stuff to a point. And you've got reach if you need it. But you will not be standing right next to the person that you're shooting. You're going to have a little bit of distance, so you got to keep that in mind. Probably not the best lens to take to a party or a family get-together, you know, for the big family portrait. That's going to be tough because you're going to have to be like two blocks down the road to be able to get them all in. Okay, that's pretty much it, with the exception of keep in mind again that it's got a 105 millimeter filter size. Those aren't readily available. Not a lot of people make them, and the ones that you find are either shit and or they're incredibly expensive. It's 105 millimeters. You're gonna have to learn how to use your camera and use your settings and figure that out and plan well if you plan on using this. All that being said, the bottom line is this is monkey approved, totally. If you have any comments, questions, or suggestions, leave them down below. As always, thanks for joining me. Be sure to like and subscribe. And remember, kids, forward and up.